Hi, hello, and welcome. Thank you so much for joining me on another holiday-inspired episode of The Crafting Coach. My name is Megan Rosendahl. I am The Crafting Coach, and this week I'm going to show you a beautiful way to warm up your winter nights. Christmas is right around the corner. This week's project can be a great last-minute addition to any holiday decorating, or it can be a great last-minute gift to a loved one. This week we're making beautiful glitter jars that can either showcase a Christmas scene or feature a design that's totally your own. These only take about 20 minutes to make and they turn out absolutely gorgeous. So here is what you'll need for this week's project. One jar or vase, anything that has a flat surface. One design, print one off the computer or design your own. Mod Podge, glitter, a scissors, a black permanent marker, and a small paintbrush. You'll also want some newspaper or extra paper for easy cleanup, and a tea candle to finish it off. Cut your design down to size and roll it so it fits inside your jar or vase. Feel free to use a little bit of tape if you want to secure it. Then grab your black permanent marker and outline your design on the outside of the glass. Be sure to use the inside paper just as a guide and pay more attention to the dark outline that you're making. It doesn't have to be perfect. I've said it once and I'll say it again. Those imperfections make your project that more personal. Now the fun, messy part. Cover your entire work surface with newspaper, then grab your Mod Podge, paintbrush, and glitter. Get just a bit of Mod Podge on your brush and paint the inside of your design bit by bit, which in my case means letter by letter. Dump an ample amount of glitter on the wet Mod Podge, pack it down a bit with your finger, and then just dump the excess off. Feel free to use another dry paintbrush to move any excess glitter out of the way before moving on to the next chunk. When you've got a bit of glitter on your newspaper, just fold it into a tube and dump it back into the canister. Keep going until you've covered everything that you want to cover. Then just give it about 5 to 10 minutes for the Mod Podge to dry before using your dry brush to remove the remaining excess glitter. That's all there is to this. Now you can just grab your tea candle and bring your beautiful creation to life. I really love how this turned out. The glitter is so beautiful with the light of the candle behind it, but it's still pretty in the daylight too. Decorate the lid with some burlap or ribbon and you've got yourself an awesome homemade Christmas gift. Well, I need to thank you very much for sitting down and taking the time to watch this video with me. I will be back next Saturday morning. We'll all have some winter-inspired projects just for you. We'll tear them apart, we'll break them down, I'll tell you what to do, I'll tell you what not to do, and hopefully we'll have just a little bit of fun along the way. Be sure to follow my Crafting Coach board on Pinterest. You can find me under Megan Rosendahl. And also be sure to follow the Aberdeen American News online and on Facebook, where all of the Crafting Coach projects are made available for you. If you have any project ideas or tips or suggestions, please don't hesitate to email me at mrosendahl@aberdeennews.com. Everyone have a very, very wonderful Christmas, and we'll see you all next week. Bye!